Yes, so how do you measure body fat? Okay, how do you measure body fat? That's it here, body fat measurement. That's what's coming up next, so stick around.
In a world awash with danger and stress, the one thing you mustn't ignore is your health. No ifs, no buts. Hop on the driving seat and take absolute control of your health with a little help from a friend. Please welcome Dr. Joe.
Yes, welcome back. I'm Dr. Joe of the drjoe.com. So today we're talking about how to measure body fat. How to measure body fat. How do you do that? Well, there are advanced methods and there are simple methods. And you know, I like simplicity. I like simplicity, yes. So, but I'll start with the advanced methods first of all. The first advanced method is Mri scan, okay? Mri scan, which is some type of imaging. I don't know if you're familiar with it. It's got to be done in the hospital. And then of course, that means it may require payment depending on where in the world you are. In the UK here, it's free, but you're not gonna get that just because you wanna measure body fat. We're not gonna do that for you in the hospital, unless there are strong indications for doing that. But usually when you do MRI scan for some other reasons, they'll see how much, you know, fat you've got there around your organs. It actually measures, MRI is very good for what we call internal fat, the visceral fat, okay? And that visceral fat is very important because once you have a lot of visceral fat, that leads to all sorts of problems, which I'm probably not going to discuss right now. So MRI scan is there, is the first method, is advanced, is expensive, especially if you live in a part of the world where you have to pay for it. And also it carries a small risk of radiation. It's a very small one. It's not important, but it's still radiation anyway. So, but that's the most reliable method of actually measuring your body fat because it tells you about the visceral fat as well as the subcutaneous fat, the fat you have underneath the skin, all right? So that's MRI scan. It's not available for everyone. So maybe we can probably put that in a corner. So what's the next best method? You can use the fat caliper. And essentially it's a little instrument. You place it, it picks up the skin, and then you measure how much body fat you've got. And then you do whatever you're doing and then come back maybe 2 weeks later and you measure it again to see whether the thickness is less than what it was the last time you measured it. So it measures the fat on your tummy as well as the fat anywhere, you know, you just pick any part of your body, in particular usually the tummy. You measure it and then it's going to give you the reading in centimeters or millimeters, and then you do it about a week or 2 weeks apart, and then you see whether you're making progress or not. So that's that. So what's the third method? Now we're going down to simple methods now, which I like, okay? Simple methods. The third one is measuring the fat around your tummy. So I just need to probably talk about this. I may need to adjust the camera down so you can see what I'm talking about. But so with this method, I had to lower the camera because I'm the only one operating. I'm a one-man team. So you got to forgive me for that. So essentially, you take a tape. Is the third method is you actually using a tape measure, the regular old reliable tape. That's what you've got. You use that and you just wrap it around your abdominal circumference. Usually you have to have a reference point so that there is consistency. You have to have a reference point, and that reference point is your belly button. You have to measure it, you know, around your belly button, okay? Of course, I'm not going to take my clothes off, otherwise I would have to, you know, actually demonstrate it for you. But essentially, you just, you know, take your tape, wrap it, you know, around your belly button area, and then you go ahead and you measure it, okay? And then next time you come around, after you've done whatever you're doing, whatever weight loss or fat loss strategies you're using, you go ahead and come back again, and then you measure and you see whether your efforts are paying off.
Yes. Okay.
So the key points to method number three using the tape measure is that you have to use a fixed point. The fixed point the belly button, that's your fixed point, is a reference point, because you need that consistency. Once you do that, you're going to get reliable readings and you can actually monitor your progress. Okay, so that's method number three. Method number four is the electronic weighing scale that shows you your body fat percentage when you step on it. Okay, now I'm going to do a demonstration of that for you, and that's what's up next.
A very simple way of monitoring your body fat percentage is using an electronic weighing scale that displays all of the parameters, including body fat percentage. This one I've got in front of me here, this is your Zero brand. There are others that you can purchase from Amazon and any other shop, but this is the one I use, and this one you can create profiles for all members of your family. So my profile will be P1, that's profile one, that's for me. My daughter will be P2, my wife will be P3, my son will be P4, and my other son will be P5. So you can create a profile on it, and every time you step on the scale, it will recognize who has stepped on it. It's funny, you know, if my daughter steps on it, now it's going to show P2. Now when I step on it, now it's going to show P1. P1 is profile one. So let's go, let me step on it. So as you can tell, it's reading, it's calculating. So profile one, my body fat percentage show that this is total body water, that's muscle, that's bone, body fat percentage, that's mine there, 17.4, and my weight is 84.5 kilograms. So it shows all of these parameters, and is very, very ideal to measure and monitor your body fat percentage in your journey, you know. I like it, and it's very affordable, and it's something that you can easily use. Turn yourself off there. So that's the way it works, and it's a very simple tool. It works, and anybody can use it.
Yeah, so as you can tell there, method number four is mixing simplicity with technology, and it works. Okay, so I use that Ozeri scale, and it helps me to monitor my body fat percentage. Okay, in summary, the four methods are MRI scan, which is beyond the reach of a lot of people, and then of course you've got a body fat caliper, and that's method number two. Method number three is using the regular reliable tape measure, and method number four is using the electronic weighing scale that shows you your body fat percentage. Okay, so that's it for this video. Don't forget to subscribe, and I usually leave a link in the description as well for you to follow to my website, my blog, and leave me a comment in the comment section, and let me know what your experience is like with monitoring your body fat. Okay, so that's it for today. Until next time, this is Dr. Joe signing out.